गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर ऑल फाइन एट होम एंड यू आर ऑल इन्जॉइंग हॉलीडेज वेरी हैप्पीली। सो टुडे वी आर स्टडी अबाउट चैप्टर नंबर 5, एडिटिंग टेक्स्ट इन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट 2010। सम टॉपिक्स वी आर स्टडीड अर्लियर, वी आर डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मेन कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वर्ड 2010। We are discuss about the enter and deleting a text, selection and editing in a document, cut, copy and paste various text, working with buttons on the toolbar, working how to work pointer in a program, work with text and character in a program. So we have discussed or recapitulate the things whatever we have studied earlier. What is Microsoft Word? Word 2010 is a word processing application program that allows you to create a variety of documents like letters, flyers, reports. Word 2010 allow you to do more with words and processing object. It is a word processing component of the Microsoft Office Suite. In earlier days we are telling you what is Office Suite. It is used to enter, edit, format, save, retrieve and print the documents. It is used to insert picture, preview the text before printing. We are also discussed about the working area, how the blank page overview is looking when we open a document. Now we are learn about the quick access toolbar continued, where we found these quick access toolbar. Quick access toolbar means we can easily save, undo and redo command used in a document. It's just located above the ribbon. The quick access toolbar lets you access common commands no matter which tab is selected. It shows the save, undo and repeat commands. You can add other tools depending on your preference. Click the drop down arrow to write on the quick access toolbar. Select the command you wish to add from the drop down menu. To choose from more commands, select and more options are there. The ruler. Ruler is basically located at the top of the and left of the document. It shows height and width of the document. It makes it easier to adjust your document very precisely with the height and the width of the document. The ruler is shown in this tab. In view tab, we can see the ruler option. Document views. Document views are of three type: print mode, read mode, web mode. Print mode is the option where we take the printout. Web mode, when we want to display our document in a web. Read mode, when only read the document. How do we select a text? So first, what we do, place the insertion point. Insertion point, that means a vertical line. I studied earlier. The insertion point next to the text you wish to select. Click the mouse while holding it down. Drag your mouse over the text to select it. Release the mouse button. You have the selected the text. A highlighted box will appear on the selected text. The highlighted text, that means whatever this text is selected, that is highlighted. How to delete a text? How to delete a highlighted text? Highlight the text you wish to delete. Then hit the delete key on the keyboard. Copy and paste. Copy text, create a duplicate of the text. Select the text you wish to copy. First of all, we need to select the text whenever we want to copy or paste. So the copy command is given on the home button. There is an icon shown in the red circle. And the copy and paste text. These lines we have copied. And the pasted location where we pasted, its cursor is shown it here. Put your insertion point where you wish to paste the document. How do we check spelling and grammar in our document? First, the automatic spelling and grammar feature is available in the words in the background to check your spelling and grammatical mistake as you type. See, there are some example. We want to write text. But if we write TEXR, it is not a spelling of text, so it shows a red wavy lines. So in the next, move the, there is a grammatical error, so there is a green wavy lines. What to wear, it's not a proper sentence, so in a wear there is a green wavy lines. Using these feature enable you to correct the mistake immediately. You can wait until you finish create the document. Spelling, check for incorrect spelling, duplicate words, incorrect capitalization. Capitalization, that means if you want to capitalize the first word of the text. Grammar, use grammatical rule in any grammatical error in a document or paragraph. It shows, we can say it. Use a grammar check feature. Suppose a TEXR, it's not a spelling of text. Red wavy lines indicate a word that is not recognized in the dictionary. Second, move the. Green wavy lines indicate a grammatical structural error in the sentence. That means there is any grammatical error in the sentence. Third, what to wear. Blue wavy lines indicate a possible contextual text here. Suppose that we want to, there is a relation, whatever is created in a sentence, there is something grammatical error. So contextual error is when a wrong word is used, but the word is spelled correctly. So where we find this? On the review tab in a proofing group, click spelling and grammar or press F7 by the keyboard. The spelling and grammar dialog box will open. Thank you. I hope you are all understand the topic.